Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In the morning when this worry and concern still hadn't gone, Hazrat Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he went to the Kaaba of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And there again, in prostration in front of the Kaaba, Hazrat Hamza radiallahu ta'ala, he's crying to Allah, he's saying that, oh Allah, these doubts in my heart, please ya Allah, take these doubts away. If this is true what is in front of me, then please clear it in my heart. He says, I had hardly finished when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala took all the shak shubha, all the doubts away from my heart. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he put assurance in my heart that this religion which I have taken on, this is the true religion, this is the straight path. He says that as soon as I felt this feeling, I went to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and I told the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about everything that had happened. Allahu Akbar, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he prayed for Hazrat Hamza that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep him steadfast and firm on the path of Islam. Standing in front of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he read a shi'r, a poem. He said, حَمِدْتُ اللَّهَ حِينَ فُؤَادِي إِلَى الْإِسْلَامِ وَالدِّينِ الْحَنِيفِ لَدِينٌ جَاءَ مِنْ رَبٍ عَزِيزٌ خَبِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ بِهِمْ لَتِيفٌ إِذَا تُلِيَتْ رَسَائِلُهُ عَلَيْنَا تَحْتُرُ دَمْعُ ذِي اللُّبِّ الْحَسِيفِ رَسَائِلٌ جَاءَ أَحْمَدُ مِنْ حَطَاهَا رَسَائِلٌ جَاءَ أَحْمَدُ مِنْ هَدَاهَا بِآيَاتٍ مُبَيِّنَةِ الْحُرُوفِ وأحمد مصطفى فينا مطاع فلا تغشوه بالقول العنيف فوالله لا نسلمه لقوم ولما نقضي فيهم بالسيوف. الله أكبر. What a point. He says that I praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for guiding me towards Islam and the deen of Ibrahim عليه الصلاة والسلام. He says لدين جاء من رب عزيز, such a religion which has come from the mighty Lord. Such a religion which has come from the mighty Lord, خَبِيرٌ بِالْعِبَادِ بِهِمْ لَتِيفٌ, a Lord which is knowing of everything that His servants do. إِذَا تُلِيَتْ رَسَائِلُهُ عَلَيْنَا, that when His message is read upon us, when His ayat and His Quran is read upon us, تَحْتُرُ دَمْعُ ذِي اللُّبِّ الْحَسِيفِ, that an أَقْلَمَنْ person's eyes, they begin flowing with the tears. رَسَائِلٌ جَاءَ أَحْمَدُ مِنْ هَدَاهَا, that such a message that Ahmad, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has brought to us, بِآيَاتٍ مُبَيِّنَةِ الْحُرُوفِ, which is totally clear, which has no doubt, which has no sort of doubt in it. وَأَحْمَدُ مُصْطَفَى فِينَا مُطَاعًا, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he is one who is followed amongst us. وَلَا تَغُشُّوهُ بِالْقَوْلِ الْعَنِيفِ, then do not try to denigrate and disgrace him. Do not try to slander him with bad words. And then the last word he says, فَوَاللَّهِ لَا نُسَلِّمْهُ لِقَوْمٍ وَلَمَّا نَقْلِ فِيهِمْ بِالسُّيُوفِ. He says, by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we will never hand over the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to any tribe. وَلَمَّا نَقْلِ فِيهِمْ بِالسُّيُوفِ, until we have not dealt with them with our swords. Allah Akbar, this was the iman of Hazrat Hamza radiallahu ta'ala anhu. After this, when the mushrikeen and the kuffar of Makkah, they saw that now Hazrat Hamza has also accepted Islam, now giving difficulty to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, causing him inconvenience and annoyance, is going to be extremely difficult. They again, they got together in a gathering and they done mashwara, they consulted each other again in approaching the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. This time they selected somebody by the name of Utbah ibn Rabi'ah. And they said to Utbah ibn Rabi'ah that you go to him and you explain to him. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and he said that, oh Muhammad, oh my nephew, no doubt your greatness is musallam, is accepted over the whole of Makkah, in our tribe, everywhere. Your greatness is accepted, your truthfulness, your honesty, your dignity is accepted, but you have caused a division amongst your people. Oh Muhammad, this thing that you are calling towards, please leave it. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then he said to him, that what is your purpose of saying and calling towards Islam? Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if your purpose is money, then we can collect so much money that no person has that much money in the whole of Makkah. If your purpose of calling towards Islam is women, then we will get you the most beautiful women of Makkah. If your purpose of calling people towards Islam is leadership and kingship. Then we accept you as our leader. We accept you. We will make you our king. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, tell us what it is so that we can present it in front of you. Allahu Akbar. Look what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says. Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he scoffed. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked him, "That Utbah, have you spoken what you had to speak?" He said, "Yes, I've spoken what I had to speak." He said, "That, O Utbah, I am the messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has given me a book, he has descended, revealed the Quran to me. And he has instructed me to tell you about his punishment and to tell you about his reward." And then the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he began reading a few ayat of the Quran. حَامِيمْ تَنْزِيلٌ مِّنَ الرَّحْمَنِ الرَّحِيمِ كِتَابٌ فُصِّلَتْ آيَاتُهُ قُرْآنًا عَرَبِيًّا لِقَوْمٍ يَعْلَمُونَ بَشِيرًا وَنَذِيرًا فَأَعْرَضَ أَكْثَرُهُمْ فَهُمْ لَا يَسْمَعُونَ وَقَالُوا قُلُوبُنَا فِي أَكِنَّةٍ مِّمَّا تَدْعُونَا إِلَيْهِ وَفِي آذَانِنَا وَقْرٌ وَمِن بَيْنِنَا وَبَيْنِكَ حِجَابٌ فَاعْمَلْ إِنَّنَا عَامِلُونَ The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he kept on reading. And Utbah ibn Rabi'ah, he sat like this. He sat mesmerized, listening to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's tilawat of the Quran. He was flabbergasted, mesmerized, listening to how beautiful this speech was. Allahu Akbar. When he got to the ayat, فَإِنْ أَعْرَضُوا فَقُلْ أَنْذَرْتُكُمْ صَاعِقَةً مِثْلَ صَاعِقَةِ عَادٍ وَثَمُودٍ Utbah, all of a sudden, he jumped up and he put his hand over the face, over the mouth of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And he said, bas, no more. O Muhammad, have raham. O Muhammad, have mercy upon us, have mercy upon us. No more. He feared that the azab, the punishment that came down upon Ad and Samud, this was going to come down. The way the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was reading, Allah Utbah, he was mesmerized. He was shocked that somebody like the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam could come with such a speech like the Quran. Seeing this, Utbah, he walked off. When he came, and Abu Jahl and all the rest of the leaders, they were standing waiting for Utbah. Utbah came a different person. Without even saying anything, Abu Jahl, he looked at Utbah and he said, Utbah is not the same person. He said, Utbah is not the same person. Utbah, have you become a Sabi? Have you become one of those people also that have left the deen? Utbah, he said, that I have heard the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allahu Akbar, subhanallah. He said, I have heard the words of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They are not the words of a poet. They are not the words of a magician. All these people, all the leaders, they straight away, they understood that so much happened. They began saying the Utbah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he has done a sihr on you, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has done magic upon you. He said, no. He said, if you want my advice, if you want my opinion, I will tell you that what I have heard from Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, I can tell you that one day Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that if you want my advice, I will tell you that leave Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam however he is. If the Arabs, they defeat and they kill Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, then you don't have anything to worry about. But if Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam overpowers the whole of Arabia, then his honor and dignity is your honor and dignity. If Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam becomes a leader and becomes a king, then his respect and his leadership is your leadership. Why? Because he is from your tribe. Allahu Akbar. You know, this is how these people would think. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us to realize the value of Quran. I just want to mention one point here. These people were kuffar, they were mushrikeen, their hearts were filled with kufr. Their hearts were filled with shirk. But even these people could feel the sweetness of Quran when the Quran would be recited in front of them. Like Walid ibn Mughira, he had said that I have heard the speech of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His speech is sweet, it has a brilliant splendor. It has fresh roots and its branches are filled with fruits. This is because he had heard the kalam of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He could feel it. Why today can the Muslims not feel this same sweetness? Why is it that when we read the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we cannot feel the same sweetness? When we open the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we begin yawning. The reason for this is because we are so indulged in sin. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he says that when a mu'min, he does one guna, when he does one sin, that sin, it acts like a black spot on his heart. When he does another sin, another black spot goes on this heart. Until one day this heart is covered. When this heart is covered, then the nur of his iman is only shining under this blackness. When the nur of Quran comes on this heart, he cannot feel. He cannot feel the sweetness, he cannot feel the brilliance of Quran. But when a servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he repents to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he asks forgiveness from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he remembers Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this blackness, it goes away. A mu'min, even in today's day and age, he will be able to begin feeling the sweetness of Quran when they begin reciting the Quran of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we look in them with Allahu Akbar, you can see that even the mushrikeen at that time, they could feel the sweetness of Quran when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam or the Sahaba, they would read the Quran. Just finally, once again when they saw that this is not working, they again, they don't mashwara, they had another gathering. And in this gathering, they said to the Prophet, they came and they approached the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and they said that, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, if you are not going to stop refuting our idols, then we have a better idea. And this idea is that you worship our idols for 1 year, and then we will worship your idols for 1 year. Hearing this, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he rejected it. But from on top, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent an ayat refuting and refusing this suggestion that they had made. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he sent down the ayat of Surah Al-Kafirun, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ وَلَا أَنَا عَابِدٌ مَا عَبَدْتُمْ وَلَا أَنْتُمْ عَابِدُونَ مَا أَعْبُدُ لَكُمْ دِينُكُمْ وَلِيَ دِينِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent these ayats rejecting and refusing the suggestion that they had made. Because worshipping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it doesn't mean that you can prescribe partners with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When a person, he worships Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants to be worshipped alone. Only one, and Allah is only one, and Allah wants to be worshipped alone. They were saying, worship our gods and worship your gods. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says that, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ, say, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that all disbelievers, قُلْ يَا أَيُّهَا الْكَافِرُونَ لَا أَعْبُدُ مَا تَعْبُدُونَ, I am not worshipping what you are worshipping, and you are not worshipping what I am worshipping, nor are you going to worship what I am worshipping, nor am I going to worship what you are worshipping. So your religion is for you and my religion is for me. Allah Akbar, these ayats, they were sent by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, refusing the suggestion that they had made, like I've just mentioned. Because they were calling the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam again towards shirk. Whether you worship Allah and others, or whether you worship others and not Allah, it is still shirk, polytheism at the end of the day. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protect us from such acts, inshallah. I just want to stop there. Next week, the seerah darsh, inshallah, will be at the same time after Asr al-Salah. Wa akhir da'wana, alhamdulillah.